Hello everyone, this is Joseph Not here and welcome back to the third part of the tutorial where I'm talking about parallelization. In the first part I was talking about parallelization and the different decomposition methods and I set up the base case. In the second part I showed you the difference between the possible decomposition methods and now I'm going to actually run a parallel simulation. I will go for that into maybe the simple folder. Okay, so I'm going to delete the processor folders. Now we have the case set up as I would have for a single simulation. Now what do you have to do? So you set up everything correctly and then you type in decompose bar. As we did before, then these four processor folders are created. Now you have to start your simulation in parallel mode. How to do that? You have a certain syntax for that. You type in MPI run, and this MPI run is actually responsible for the communication between your cores. So for the communication between your processors, your subdomains. MPI run minus NP, this is the number of processes. We want to start four processes. So MPI run will start four compressible interfoams. And then we have to type in which process to start. Compressible interfoam. Okay, so this will start four compressible interfoams, but very important, we have to type in minus parallel in order to tell OpenFOAM to calculate in parallel mode. Otherwise, what would happen? MPI run would start four single compressible interfoams and then those would do the same calculations four times at the same time and then it would write out the results and override the same results over each other. So this does not make sense to do that. You want to do the simulations in parallel mode. So the first process will calculate the equations in this part, actually for the simple case in this subdomain, and the second core will calculate the equations in this subdomain and so on. So minus parallel is very important. And then I could now press enter, but I don't want to do that. Actually, I want to write out the output that would come into the terminal. I want to write it into a text file because I want to take a look at the text file later on. So you can do that by writing .log, log dot and then whatever you want, compress. And this sign will bring the output into the text file called log.compress. You can call this as you want. You can call this log.compressible interfoam. You don't even have to call it log. You can call it as you want. So this will start an MPI run and MPI run will start four compressible interfoams in parallel mode and the output will be written into the text file called log.compress. Writing this command every time typing in MPI run minus NP4 compressible interfoam is a little bit tedious. I'm a lazy person, so usually what I do, I take this command and I write it into a text file, which I usually call go. And I save this and I just execute this text file. As you see there, you have text file and then the system will actually execute this command. But I have to tell my system that go is something that I want to execute and I can do this with the command chmod plus x and go. And now, as you see, the color of my go file changed. Now it is executable. And how to do it? I could type in the entire path, so my home and my OpenFOAM installation. Don't do it at home, I just want to show you. Then multiphase, it was in laminar, depth, charge. Oops, no, not multiphase compressible interfoam. Yes, laminar and depth charge 2D, simple and go. And now press enter and then it would execute this. But this is also a very long path. So if you don't want to type this in every time, then what you can do, you can type in dot slash and go, and this dot tells you the system that you want to execute something in your working directory. So this dot replaces all this path here. So dot slash go space and, don't forget the and, like with ParaView, and so it runs in the background. So with dot slash go, I can now execute the parallel simulations. So what this does, this will take a look at my working directory, find this go file, and execute whatever is within this go file. And this is npirun minus np4 compressible interfoam in parallel mode. And please write the output into a text file and not into the terminal. And then do it in the background so I can do something meanwhile in the terminal. So now I actually press enter. And now the simulation started. Now nothing is really happening. What to do? Now we have this log.compress. So here we have our output. Now how I can take a look at it in gedit. Usually you never do that. Gedit. Let's just open up. And now you see that my system is writing here into this text file. But then if I want to take a look at the output after I opened up gedit, then I have to refresh it, and this is very, very tedious, and I usually don't do it that, and nobody does that. You can take a look at the results here in the terminal with nano or vi, but actually what you do, there is this command called tail, and this brings out the last 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 lines out of this text file. So if I go up and enter, and now I can follow the simulation. But this is also a lot of work. So what you can actually do, you can do this automatically with this minus F. The tail command will do that for you. So it will always read out the last line that is being written into this text file. And now this really looks like what we saw in the previous tutorials, that the output is coming into the terminal, but actually this is not true. The output is going into the text file and we are reading it out of the text file. And now I can press Ctrl C, and this does not stop the simulation. The simulation is running in the background. This just only terminates this tail command. So with this, now I can follow my simulation. Now let's take a look. It does not save in the simulation in the OpenFOAM case folder, but it is saving now in the processor folders. So you have your results here in the processor folder. Okay, now how to take a look at what is happening. There is this command top, which is very similar to the task manager in Windows. And here you see the processes which use most of the CPU and the memory. So for example, you see these four compressible interfoam processes. Another possibility is PSVUX. This will list up all the processes. As you see, there is a lot going on in Ubuntu in the background. And now here you see the four compressible interfoams and the npirun command. You also see my ffmpeg and Audacity. For example, with Audacity, I'm recording my voice. So here you see really all the processes that are running. And what you also see, you see the CPU usage and the memory usage. And as you see here, the CPU usage is not very good. Why? Because I'm also running this FFmpeg and Audacity. So I'm using my four cores for the simulations and also for other things. So if you want to use your laptop or your PC for Firefox or for something else, it does not make sense to use all the cores for your simulations, because those other processes will slow down your simulations. But for demonstration purposes, I'm doing it. And now what you have here is the so-called PID, the process ID number, and this number identifies each process. And with this, you can then stop the simulations. But at this, I will do that later on. Now let's take a look at PSVUX. And as you see now, there are no compressible interfoams. Why? Because the simulation stopped. We actually reached at the end time. We reached 0.5, and now we can take a look at the results. Okay, for that I will create the dummy file for ParaView, and I will take a look at the results. I'm going to open up a second ParaView. Okay, now with the dummy file, and now I can press apply. However, as I mentioned, in my case directory there is nothing, and the results are in the processor folders. How to tell this? ParaView, here you have this possibility to change your case type from reconstructed case to decomposed cases, and this is what we actually want, because if we select here decomposed case, then ParaView will take a look at the results in processor folders. And now, as you see here, we have pressure values, maybe these pressure values of 10 bar within our sphere, and outside of it we have 1 bar as we set up the initial values. Like this, and alpha.water, here we have our liquid, and here we have our air, and also our air here. Sometimes this does not work for whatever reason, then you just take a look at it with Foam2VTK. And I'm going to show you that a little bit later on, how to do the Foam2VTK command with this parallel results. Okay, but now let's take a look at the in the decomposed mode. Okay, now I can actually browse through the results, and what's happening, the high pressure gas is pushing the liquid in the direction of a walls, and actually in the direction of the top wall, and we have a movement of a free surface, but after a while the gravitational acceleration or the force is pulling down the liquid in the direction of our lower wall. And now I didn't want to do that. Now let's just take a look at the flow. It is very cool flow, especially in the 3D case. So here it is going down, and then the liquid is sloshing around. It's going up again, then along the walls up until the very top, if I remember correctly. Yes, to the very top, and then on the top, and then it the water is dripping down in the center, and then it's going to the side. So it is a very cool simulation. And run the simulation, the 3D simulation, as a homework, because it really looks nice. Okay, now we reached 0.5, so this is what the results look like. You can just go through the temperature and the velocity yourself. Okay, now if you want to execute Foam2VTK or sample, you want to sample your results, Then you need your results here in the case folder and not in the processor folder. How to bring back your results from the processor folders? And there is this command called reconstruct par, enter, and this will actually bring your results together into one case in your case folder. Now let's wait till this finishes. It will do it for all the time steps that we saved. And now we have the results here in the case folder for the original mesh with 12,800 entries. And for example, if I take a look at the results at this point of time, alpha.water, here you see now we have a list of 12,800 entries. So for the actual mesh. And now at this point, I can just delete the processor folders because I have all my results in my case folder. And now I can execute foam2vtk, for example. And now I will have all the results for in the VTK file, in the VTK folder, I mean. Okay, now VTK folder, and here I have all the results. And I could use now sample or whatever I want. Okay, so actually I want to show you how to stop a parallel simulation. I'm going to do that in the hierarchical case. So to recap, what to do? You set up the case as you want, as you wish, and then you type in decompose par. This will create 2, 4, 8, 16, as many cores you have, as you want, and as many you want to use. Here I want to use 4, and so I have 4 processor folders, and now I could again set up the Go file, but actually what I'm going to do, and this is what you should do, also you set it up once and then you copy it. Now I have also the Go file with the MPI run, compressible interfoam, and now I type in, so I typed in decompose par, then I copied the Go file into my folder, and now I can execute .go. And actually this is what you usually do in a parallel simulation. Enter. Now simulation started. We see our compressible interfoams within top, and in PSVUX we can tail the output. Very good. But now I want to kill this. I want to stop the simulations because maybe you see that you made an error and you want to stop it. But it is running in the background, so you have to do it. You cannot just press Ctrl C because this will not do anything to the simulation. You can stop the simulation with the command kill -9, and then you take the process ID of either the MPI run command or one of the compressible interfoams. You can also put all 5 process IDs here or just one as you wish. Press enter, and now killed MPI run, compressible interfoam, and blah blah blah. Good, now the simulation is not running anymore. As you see, it stopped at this point of time. So this is how you can stop your simulation. Okay, as a homework, as I mentioned, do the simulations of the three-dimensional case. Of this case, this will take a while because there you have a lot of cells. But take a look at the results and run the simulation. And also evaluate your results. And it will be a very good exercise for you. Good. At this point, I would like to stop recording. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and that you learned something. I would like to thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.